Christian Counselor's Manual, Session 21, 圣人辅导第二十一讲 Chapter 8, 第八章 The Reconciliation / Discipline Dynamic, 和好和纪律圣经辅导的动力 Introduction, 引言 Reconciliation, God's way to resolve problems, 和好上帝解决问题的方法。We must consider next an important biblical principle that provides a basis for hope by spelling out the biblical dynamic that leads to change. 下一步我们必须考虑一个重要的圣经原则，它指出圣经如何改变生命的动力，因此这个原则是提供盼望的基础。The principle may state it simply as follows. 简言之，这个原则就是 Interpersonal problems between Christians must be solved. 基督徒必须解决与其他信徒的人际关系问题的。Perhaps this principle is best exemplified by the reconciliation / discipline dynamic. This dynamic is described in Matthew 18, verses 15 to 20. 和好和纪律或者管教的动力最能够说明这个圣经原则。马太福音18章从第15到第20节描述这个动力的。The reconciliation / discipline dynamic puts an end to loose ends in Christian relationships. 和好和纪律的动力能够解决所有基督徒之间关系的问题。That is what it's all about. Christ intended for it to do just that. 这个动力就是为了解决这些人际关系问题的。这个是主耶稣的原意。One of the greatest difficulties between husbands and wives, parents and children, and various members of a congregation who have had poor interpersonal relations,is a problem of loose ends. 夫妻之间、亲子之间、会友之间常见的难处就是人际关系中没有解决的问题。Loose ends are those interpersonal problems between Christians that remain unresolved. 基督徒往往有这些尚未解决的人际关系问题。Loose ends.Problems between Christians should not continue unresolved. 基督徒之间不可以有什么尚未解决的问题的。When they do, strength is sapped from the congregation, and members work at cross purposes. 若是如此，教会的力量必然会削弱，会有会朝着相反的方向从事侍奉。Unresolved problems hurt everyone and dishonor Christ's name. 没有解决的问题伤害所有信徒，同时羞辱基督的名。There is no place, therefore, for such loose ends in the church. 因此，教会不可以容忍这些没有解决的问题的存在。God does not allow for loose ends. 上帝不容许这种的状态存在的。Rather, he insists that every personal difficulty that arises must be settled. 他坚持每一项人际关系问题都必须解决。Whatever comes between Christians must be removed. 基督徒之间的障碍必须除掉。Every such difference must be cleared up by reconciliation. 解决每一项问题的方法就是和好。Footnote 1, 注脚一. People often ask, wouldn't it better just to let a matter die and not raise the question afresh, thereby starting more trouble?
让事情自然地消失吧。我们不再提这个问题，就不会有新的麻烦出现了。这岂不是更好呢？
The issue resolves itself to this.
问题的症结是 whether or not the offended person really finds it possible to let the problem die，
被得罪的那一方是否真的有可能让这个问题自然的消失。
Proverbs 10:12， 箴言第十章十二节， Hatred stirs up strife，
仇恨眺望争端。
But love covers a multitude of sins，
但爱能遮盖很多的罪。
Plainly， every rub and offense cannot be raised and settled，
当然我们不可能提出每一项大大小小的冒犯去解决他们的。
We must learnIn love to forgive and pass by many slights, annoyances, and offenses.
有很多别人冒犯我们的事，我们必须学习用爱心饶恕。
Christ is not speaking of these in Matthew 5 and 18.
耶稣基督在马太福音第五章和第十八章不是在讨论这些事。
There in Matthew 5:23,
这里在马太福音第五章二十三节，
He is considering a case where a brother has or holds something against another.
他讨论的个案是一位弟兄向另外一位弟兄怀怒。
And when it is necessary to regain one's brother,
另外在什么情况之下需要再次得到怀怒的那方。
Matthew 18:15,
马太十八章十五节。
Rather, he speaks of those offenses that brethren find it difficult to cover.
耶稣所讨论的是那些弟兄们呢难以爱心遮盖的那些的罪。
If a matter is likely to rattle around inside or carry over till the next day, it should be handled.
一件事，假如继续在心里面干扰我们，直到第二天。那么我们就必须正视它了。
To put it another way,
用另外一个方法来讲，
If an offense drives a wedge between Christian brothers, the wedge must be removed by reconciliation.
一次的冒犯假如成为两位弟兄之间的嫌隙，就必须用和好去解决它。
To say the third way,
用第三种方法来说，
Anything that causes an unreconciled condition to exist between brethren must be dealt with.
任何导致弟兄之间一种不和好的状态存在，就必须处理了。
End of footnote 1.
注脚一结束。
And for that purpose, God graciously provided a method by which this can be accomplished.
上帝就是为了这个目的设立了一个达成和好的方法，这是他的恩典。
In Matthew 5:21-26, Christ says,
耶稣基督在马太第五章二十一到二十六节说，
If you are offering your gift at the altar,
你假如在祭坛献祭，
And you realize that you have done something against your brother, or he thinks you have,
想起你做了一件冒犯你弟兄的事，或者他认为你做过这种的事。
Drop your gift.
你必须把祭物就留在那里。
And first go,
先去。
And get the matter straightened out with your brother.
与弟兄解决这个问题。
Footnote 2.
注脚二。Note the kake and the eche, both of which are in emphatic positions. 注意 kake and eche 两个希腊字都是、为了强调那里那里，意思就是说就在当场，就在祭坛的面前。
Right on the spot, in front of the altar.
Then, tote, at that time, then and only then, he continues, may you come back and finish your act of worship.耶稣基督继续说，到了那时，唯有到了那个地步，你才可以回来完成你的敬拜。
These words clearly indicate that there is an urgency
to reconciliation. 这些词汇清楚说明和好是迫切的事。God says go first. 上帝说先去。Indeed, in Christ's example, reconciliation takes precedence over worship.
诚然，基督举例说明和好比敬拜更为优先呢。
Surely that must be one of the striking features in the example chosen.
这肯定是耶稣基督所选的例子最突出的一面。
By using so bold a contrast as that between worship and reconciliation, he intended to underscore the importance and the priority of reconciliation.
耶稣这么大胆地把敬拜和和好鲜明地对照，就是为了强调和好的重要 和优先性。
Unreconciled relationships, therefore, constitute emergency priorities that may not be handled casually or at one's leisure.
因此，没有和好的关系是紧急的优先，不可随意要找空闲的时间才来处理它。
In Matthew 18, 在马太福音十八章那里， The other side of the question is handled.
耶稣也处理问题的另外一方。
If your brother has done something against you,
你的弟兄若做了什么得罪你的事，
again, you must go,
你也要去的。
It is always your obligation to make the first move, and so it is his.
做出第一步永远是你的责任，同时也是他的责任。
You may never say he should have come to me.
你不可以说他应该来找我才对啊。
Jesus does not allow for that.
耶稣并不容许。
Whether you have done something to him or he has done something to you,
不论是你做了得罪他的事，或者是他做了得罪你的事，
In either case, Matthew 5, Matthew 18, you are to go.
无论如何，你必须去的。不论是马太第五章或者马太第十八章的个案，
Christ left no loopholes.
主耶稣并没有留下任何的漏洞。
He covered all the bases.
他处理了每一种的可能性。
Picture two brothers who have had a quarrel and go off in a huff.
试想两位弟兄争吵怒气一发就分手了。
When they both cool down,
他们两位都冷静下来的时候，
ideally,
最理想的情况就是，
they ought to meet one another on the way to each other's house, seeking reconciliation.
他们两人都在去找对方的路上见面了。
Christ says,
基督说，
that both of them are obligated to seek reconciliation.
他们两个人都必须寻求和好。
It does not matter who was at fault.
不论谁错。
Section 1, 第八章第一部分， The three steps, 三个步骤。Reconciliation, then, is the answer to loose ends in interpersonal problems between Christians.
因此和好就是解决人际关系问题的方法。
But what happens if one of the parties refuses to be reconciled?
但是若有一方不愿意和好，怎么办？
Christ also anticipated that question in Matthew 18.
主耶稣在马太福音十八章也预期了这个可能性的。
First,
首先，
A brother or sister must go to the other privately in the attempt to square matters. That may not mean just one visit. He must make every possible attempt to do this.
第一步，一位弟兄或者姐妹要私下的去尝试处理这个问题，可能不止一次的探访，他必须用尽方法来寻求和好的。
But if he exhausts that means, if he tries and tries, yet to no avail, because the other steadfastly refuses to be reconciled.
假如用尽方法，不断的尝试都不成功，因为对方坚持拒绝和好。
Then he must take a second step.
那么他必须采取第二步了。
Jesus directs that in such situations, 耶稣指示在这种的情况之下 he must take one or two others with him and go to seek reconciliation again.
他必须带一两位去再次寻求和好。
These others become arbiters or counselors who try to persuade the brother to be reconciled.
这些其他的人成为裁判者或者辅导员，尽力劝那位弟兄和好。
Footnote 3, 注脚三。Notice that the possibility of one or more, a team of counselors, is contemplated.
注意，这里有可能是一个辅导的团队。
They become involved and try to bring the two parties together once again by helping them to straighten out the relationship and possibly assisting them in reaching a solution to any problem or problems that may have been the occasion for the separation.
他们参与这件事，他们投入了这件事，努力的尝试去帮助双方解决他们之间的问题，可能帮助解决一些导致不和的事。
They too must work at this, perhaps making several visits, if necessary, until they have achieved reconciliation, or are convinced that they have done all that it is possible for them to do to no avail.
他们也必须努力地这样做，可能要多次的探访，直到他们得到和好，或者确保他们尽了一切努力而不成功。
Reluctantly, if they have failed, at this point, they become witnesses, and the whole matter must be brought officially before the church.
他们若不成功，到这地步他们就没有选择，就成为见证人了。整件事就必须正式的带到教会的面前。
Then, formal discipline takes place.
现在正式的纪律开始执行。
The church, represented by its elders, now officially, that is through its officers acting in the presence of and with the authority of the risen Christ, seeks to bring about reconciliation.
教会由众长老做代表，教会现在正式的努力寻求和好。正式的意思就是说，透过那些任职的治理者，就是牧师长老们，在基督的面前，带着基督复活的基督所赋予的权柄，努力地寻求和好。
If the elders also fail after exhausting every means,
但长老们若也失败，用尽所有方法之后失败，
the member must be solemnly excommunicated.
这位会友必须严肃地被开除他的会籍的。
Footnote.4,
注脚四。
A believer, as a member of Christ's church, is entitled to all of the privileges and blessings of church discipline.
作为基督教会的肢体或者会友，一位信徒有权获得教会纪律的一切的权益和福分。
Neither the individual who is offended,nor the church has the right to withhold either informal or formal discipline from the offender.
被得罪的那一方或者教会都没有权利不让当事人接受教会的管教的。
It is sin to do so.
如此的做是犯罪。
Remember,
不要忘记
Christ has promised to be present in a special way in the process of church discipline.
耶稣基督曾应许，当教会执行管教的时候，他会特别同在的。
There am I in their midst
我就在他们中间。Excommunication never takes place for committing the sin that occasioned the process in the beginning.
开除会籍永远不是因为在整件事开始的时候得罪的人犯的那个罪。
Excommunication always occurs when one rejects the authority of the risen Christ.
开除会籍必定是因为有人拒绝复活的基督的权柄。
He is excommunicated for contumacy.
他是因为不服权而被开除的。
One is excommunicated then, not for adultery, but for failure to repent and be reconciled.
因此某某人被开除会籍不是因为犯了奸淫，乃是没有悔改，没有与对方和好。
The sin that occasioned discipline may have been relatively small, quote unquote, in its effects.
导致被开除会籍的罪，就是起初所犯的罪，它的后果似乎是比较小。
But to that sin is added the enormously significant sin of the rejection of Christ himself as he demands repentance through his representatives.
但现在要加上不服权的罪，这是严重的，是在基督透过他的代表吩咐悔改之后拒绝了耶稣基督他自己。
Excommunication occurs when men act like Nabal.
当有人好像拿拔那样子做的时候，他就被开除会籍的。
He is such a worthless man that no one can speak to him. 1 Samuel 25:17.
拿拔是愚蠢的人，没有人能够和他讲话的。撒母耳记上25:17.
As Christ puts it,
正如耶稣基督这样说，
He will not hear or listen to the church.
他不听教会。
The people of God were destroyed, and God declared that there is no remedy.
这样做是破坏上帝的子民，就是教会。上帝宣告他无药可救。
Not because of their sin, 不是因为他们犯了罪， but because of their refusal to repent of it,
那是因为他们拒绝为罪悔改。
Their stiff-necked attitude toward God,
是为了他们在上帝面前谨慎刚硬的态度。
Refer to 2 Chronicles 36:11-21,
参考历代志下26:11-21.
End of footnote 4.
注脚4结束。
At this point,
到了这个地步，
the matter has moved over the line from mere reconciliation to formal discipline.
整件事就是从只是和好进展到正式执行纪律的阶段了。
But even the discipline has reconciliation in view.
但就算是执行纪律，目的仍然是和好。
Excommunication is not an end in itself.
开除会籍不是至终的目的。
But at least temporarily it settles the matter.
不过暂时让问题告一段落就是了。
Hopefully, this serious act itself at length will bring the offender to repentance.
大家盼望这个严厉的措施最后会领当事人来悔改的。
If the supposed brother or sister will not hear the church,
这位弟兄或者姐妹若不听教会，
he becomes a heathen and publican.
他就成为与外邦人和税吏一样。
That is outside the church, excommunicated.
换言之，他就在教会以外，是一位被开除者。
When he becomes like a heathen and a publican,
当他成为好像外邦人或税吏一样的时候呢，
Even then, members of the church must seek to counsel him with a view to restoring him in repentance.
就算在那个地步，教会的会友仍然需要辅导他，目的是让他悔改，被恢复，就是恢复与耶稣基督与教会
与其他信徒的关系的。Paul's comments on the purpose of church discipline in 1 Timothy 1:20, 2 Thessalonians 3:14 and 15, 1 Corinthians 5:5, 9 and 11, 2 Corinthians 2:5 to 8 are clear about this matter.
保罗在讨论教会纪律的目的的时候说得非常的清楚的。提摩太前书第一章20节，帖撒罗尼迦后书3:14-15，哥林多前书5:5-9-11，最后哥林多后书2:5-8。下面呢，作者要进入到第二部分，就是 The purposes and benefits of discipline， 教会执行纪律的目的和好处。我们下次继续。Thank you.